Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we will see applications of ultrasonic waves. We know ultrasonic waves are basically sound waves of very high frequency. And the frequency of ultrasonic wave is more than 20 kilohertz. So it has huge number of applications. So let us see what are the applications of ultrasonic waves. The first application is sonar. Sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging. It works on the principle of echo sounding. This is used to measure the depth of seabed, or we can say submarine object. We will see how it is used to measure the depth of seabed. Now, let us consider this is the water surface. And we'll consider this is bed, that is seabed. Now, here we have one receiver and transformer. Here we'll consider we have a receiver and here the transformer. Now, the transformer will transmit ultrasonic wave in the water. It will travel a distance and reflect back from the seabed. Now, distance covered is D, but here the distance for the going path and then reflected path. Here we have two times distance. We have to find out what is the time for sending the ultrasonic wave, that is T1, and T2 is the time for receiving the ultrasonic wave. So, in this case, we know the formula, that is velocity is equal to distance upon time. Now, our aim to find out depth of sea means distance. So, we'll write here distance is equal to velocity into time. Now, distance covering, that is two times, we'll write here 2D is equal to velocity. T is the time between the sending ray and the receiving ray. So, here we will write down T2 minus T1. Now, this is the velocity of ultrasonic wave in a sea water. It has some value. So, by using this formula, distance is equal to V T2 minus T1 upon 2. So, by using this formula, we can find out depth of sea. So, here we can say D is depth of sea. So, this is the main use of the sonar. Second application of ultrasonic wave is detection of flaws in a metal. Again, this works on the principle of echo sounding. Let us consider a metal surface. Again, here we have a transmitter and the receiver. Transmitter will transmit ultrasonic wave. It will reflect back from the discontinuity of the metal and come back to the receiver. So, we have to find out what is the time for sending and the receiving. Let us say T1 and T2. And in this way, we can find out the distance, that is the thickness of the metal. Now, suppose there is some crack or some impurity present in the metal. Now, again we will keep this device here, that is transmitter and the receiver. Now, transmitter will transmit the signal, that is ultrasonic wave. But now, there is a discontinuity. It can be crack in the metal. From that discontinuity, ultrasonic wave will reflect back. and receiver will receive the ultrasonic wave back. Again, we will find out time, that is T1 dash and T2 dash. In this case, time was more when there is no floods. But if there is a floods, time is less. Again, by using formula, that is velocity is equal to distance upon time. We have here distance to time, that is 2d is equal to vt. So, d is equal to vt by 2. So, by using this formula, we can find out the distance at which that crack is present in the metal. Third application is ultrasonic drilling. Ultrasonic waves are used to produce holes in a very hard metal, for example, diamond or quartz crystal. Next application is ultrasonic welding. We know in the process of welding, we have to use temperature, that is high heat. But some of the metal will change their property because of the high temperature. That's why in that case, we use ultrasonic welding so that the property will not change and purpose will also follow. So, these are the some important applications of ultrasonic waves. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and please subscribe Ekeeda.